Well, hi folks, this is Darren with My RV Works. A lot of folks that are watching our videos ask us questions, and this is an opportunity for us to jump in and maybe answer some of those questions. So if you like this, we're going to be doing a lot more of these things, and every one of them's got a little different feel to it. We'll jump into some different topics and things like that. If you like this kind of content, make sure you click that subscribe button, ring the bell, those types of things. That way, every week or so often when we come out with this kind of a content, you'll be notified right away. So without any further ado, let's go over to the shop and start answering some of these questions. Thanks for watching. The next question is coming in from Robert in Sedona, Arizona. So, hey Robert. Now, he's got a RV that's got a Schwintek slide room, which is that Lippert in-wall slide room. We've done a couple videos on those, and in fact, we're going to be coming out, I don't know what order you're going to watch these in, but I'm going to be coming out with another video where I'm going to kind of go through some of those a little bit deeper than I did last time. The previous video that I did, we'll make a link to it, where I was showing you all the carcasses, I felt kind of rushed. It was in an industrial kind of a setting, and so we're going to redo that, where I'm going to be a little bit slower, and I really want to, it's a privilege to work with you, and I really want to make sure that I'm paying that back to you guys. You give me your attention, and I want to make sure it's worth it. Now, so having said that, Robert's got a question on his control module. Now I have a control module right here, and this is the one he's talking about. So if you have a Lippert in-wall slide room, if you have a Schwintek, even if you have a thin, what is it called? Oh shoot, I went to school on it. Slim rack. Yeah, slim rack. A lot of them use the same. Now the slim rack and the Schwintek, their controllers are different, but they look very similar. And I did a homework assignment for you guys previously where I want you to find your module that looks like this on a fair weather day, Chamber of Commerce kind of weather, where there is no air issues and nothing's gone awry. I want you to find this in your RV. This is going to be your lifesaver, knowing where this is located in your RV. Should something happen and you need to do a recovery, okay? You need to know where this is. Rule of thumb is it'll always be accessible when the slide room is stuck in or out. So it's not like going to be stuck somewhere where you can't get to it if the slide room's in. I worked on one just yesterday and we had to take the guy's bed apart, but that's where it was, okay? And the slide room was stuck in. Now, what Robert's issue is, he's been working with a technician, and they have determined that this control module is bad. And in his notes here, the way he's getting one green and nine red blinks. So what I'm going to do, so in this little window here is these little LEDs. They'll light up. Okay, it's right. These little LEDs right there, they're going to light up for us, okay? And so on this module right here, you will see, what does that say right there? One blink and two blink. It's going to tell you that it's motor one or motor two. So here's motor one, here's motor two. And so the harnesses are connected to the bottom. If I put this back together like a Lego. So here's motor one's harness and here's motor two's harness. These are little match marks that I create in the field to tell me, so I'll put like for motor two, two little Sharpie pin marks, and on the harness itself, I'll have two marks. And that way, you know, when I'm working on them, I know that it's idiot proof, you know, that this matches. But if you look here, what I'm gonna show you is he's getting one green. Okay, it says green LED, is he's getting one green, so that tells us the problem is on motor one, and he's getting nine reds, hall power short to ground. Now down here, hall power is a brown wire, okay? So in your wire harness, I should have grabbed one, I've got them. In your wire harness that comes out of this connector, you've got all these colors here. And the brown one, this module is saying, hey, the brown wire is shorted to ground. That's what this is telling you, human. And the thing I like about the Schwintek is it pretty much diagnoses itself. Most of the time, what this problem is where it is found, okay? And what are some other things that you could have found in there? Let's see here. Here, let me do it this way, I'm reading it backwards. Wire short between controller and motor. Motor short circuit, excessive motor current, low battery. See, these are all the things that as a technician, I like to know this kind of stuff, but even as an operator, as an RVer, wouldn't it be nice to know? At least it gives you a starting point, okay? But his question specifically is, now that we know that he's getting motor one short to ground, so that's the brown wire is shorter to ground, okay? That's what he's getting. And so typically what you would do is like, okay, well, is a problem with the motor? Is it with the wire? Or is it with the controller? So what you would do is you would just switch these wires over. So now the physical motor one is connected to connection two, and physical motor two is connected to condition one. Clear all your faults and run your motor again. If the problem was with the motor or the wire, then it would follow that now you're going to get two green blinks. instead of one. Same 9 code, but you would expect to get 2 green blinks. Therefore, you would say you have a problem with your wiring harness because it's saying the wire short to ground. So we have our controller, which has all of our error codes on it, and there's some other information on here as well that I want you to be aware of. How to manually override. And so press this, okay, so deep inside again, where are we at? Okay, so deep inside, there's this little button right there. You can hear it clicking. So there's a button right there that you can access with the cover on. You can see the button right in there. Okay, so you're going to push that 6 times and hold the 7th. You're going to press the button 6 times and hold down the 7th, and then the lights are going to do a little dance for you. Okay, use the normal slide controller switch to retract the room. So what this does is when you push this button, it's going to render the, it's going to ignore top of your motor, right? You have all these Hall effect sensors that this part turns, okay? And so when you are rendering it, basically it's going to ignore all this and it's just going to send power to black and red, which is going to run just the motor part, okay? So when he, I only have one harness with me. So when you switch the problem here to here, the problem should change and you should get 2 blinks instead of 2 reds, I'm sorry, 2 greens instead of 1 green if you were getting it before. So these are some ways you could troubleshoot it, and it sounds like what him and the technician did was exactly correct. And the problem stayed with 1 green and 9 reds, even when they switched this between the two. That tells us that it's the controller, the problem's in the controller, not on the wire. Now, Robert's specific question, Robert from Arizona, says, how common is it for these to go bad, and are there any tips on protecting it, okay? I've been working on, let's see, I became an RV tech in 2011, and I think I've replaced maybe 3 of these things, but I've worked on probably over 100, or probably more than 100 Schwintek problems, and continuing on to the day. What's wrong with this one? This is one of the ones that I replaced, and let me see if I can get in close. Let me look where I'm going for. Okay, it's right where my finger is. Right there, there was a lightning strike. There's a glare, you can see a little bit of the... There was a lightning strike and it took out that pin right there, okay? And so that's what happened on this one. And that's why I have it. Normally I used to throw these away and now I'm keeping them to do show and tell. And so yes, these are expensive, $300-$400 or something like that. But they're, the other one that I had to replace, it was mounted on the wall and there was a water line that ran over it that leaked and it dripped inside. So these are very robust, is what I would say. Of all the times I've worked on these things, it's rarely this. This one went bad because of lightning strike, the other one because of water dripping down inside, okay? And the other one I did replace. I don't know that I found out, it was just something wrong with it. But so how would you protect that? They do have things you can control where your power connects. You could put like a choke or some kind of a MOV would be for AC, I believe, but they have little chokes that you could put if you really wanted to be that anal on protecting these things. But the cost of some of that protection stuff is about as much as one of these things. And in 10 years I've been doing this, I've only replaced 3. I think, you know, now that doesn't mean you're going to replace it and it's not going to break again. I may have just jinxed you. Anyway, so it sounds to me like you did a good job troubleshooting it. It sounds to me that based on your notes, Robert, that that is what the problem is. And I just wanted to take a few more minutes to go over some more of the stuff on these controllers, okay? I'll make a link down below. It'll be an Amazon affiliate link. If you need one or you need any of these things, we'll put links down below. You can click it. You're going to pay the same through Amazon, but we get a little percentage of that sale. So that's a way you can show some love to help us out here. And so, Robert, I hope that... I'm just confirming what you found, and you know, maybe some other viewers that are watching this, they can get a little bit more familiar with this. Some people don't take the time to read this, but it really is great, and it gives you your wire code. Check this out. Where's the end of my wire? Right here. If you look here, look at all the colors of the wire right there. Focus. I'm not on the back of the camera where I can push the focus button, and it matches these colors right here. So if it's telling you you have a short to ground, that means this brown wire's got the issue, and it's the Hall effect wire. And so if you follow that up to the motor, here's our motor here. And here's our brown wire coming in on the top of the motor. And I've mentioned in another video, and I'll mention it again too, usually these motors themselves do not go bad. Now, I have seen the motors go bad because water will drip down and corrode all this inside. But typically what we see is the little screw that holds this motor in. This motor, the screw will fall out and the motor will spin around and it'll rip these wires out. And these motors are 200 to 300 or somewhere in that neighborhood. A lot of times I do stock a solder iron with me in my service trailer. And so sometimes I've made the repairs by just cutting the wires back and resoldering them right onto here. And because the motor was fine, it's just the wires got ripped out. So you can maybe make your own repair if you're skilled at soldering or you know somebody skilled at soldering. So there's a tip there. So Robert, I hope that helps. All I've done is confirmed what it sounds like you've already done. For spare parts on these things, I would stock a spare. If you have a Schwintek in your RV, I would at least stock a spare cord. And the reason I would stock a spare cord is because typically of all the times I've worked on these things, I've got a 35 footer as a tech. That's for me, I might need to go far. But again, I'll make links to low. You can get one that's the length that you might need. But for spare parts, I don't know that I would stock a spare motor. I don't know that I would stock a spare controller, but I would stock a spare motor harness. And they've got these funky ends on them. That's why they're fancy. So the black kind, the black end plugs into the motor and the white end plugs into the control module. So, and then this 35 footer here. So again, we'll make links below, and Amazon's got a lot of this stuff if you're okay buying from them. And anyway, okay, that's all I got for this question. We're gonna go jump into another one. Thanks for watching. Well, folks, that's all the time I have right now to answer some of these questions. We try to keep these things short and compact. But if this was helpful, give us a thumb up, subscribe to our channel. If you like this kind of a content, you could support us on Patreon. And we also have some links on our website, myrvworks.com, where you can get to our merchandise store, our tool store, because we're making tools now, and also some links on Amazon, where some affiliate links, where we'll kind of put stuff down there that we use a lot. So it's a pleasure. It's a privilege to answer your questions. I really enjoy doing that as I get time. So thank you so much from all of us on My RV Works. Thank you for watching. Happy campers. Say My RV Works.